Today we're going to be taking a look at one of the top ARs in the game, the Farah 83. This gun is better than the M13. Post 50 meters, it's got a faster time to kill. In fact, it's insanely quicker to kill than the M13. And this thing has about as much recoil as the M13. And as we know, that is next to nothing. Anybody can use this gun. The recoil is non-existent and you're going to beam enemies from any distance. Now, in the closer ranges, it's not got the fastest time to kill. And yes, it isn't going to be as quick as the AMAX or the Cold War AK, but ultimately, at those longer ranges, you're not going to be missing your shots. Post 150 meters, you're still going to be able to beam your enemies, whereas on the AMAX and the Cold War AK, you're going to struggle to hit them. Now, just before we get into the attachments for this weapon, my viewers know me for the No Nonsense Guide, where I'm going to tell you the attachments to the weapon in the first minute of the video. So let's get that underway. For the muzzle, we're taking the Gru Suppressor. This helps keeping you off of the minimap, as well as vertical recoil control, bullet velocity, and effective damage range. The key points there are probably just keeping you off the minimap. All the other aspects are just as equal as each other on this gun, and it's a great choice. Moving over to the barrel, we are taking the 19.5 inch Liberator. This helps out with your bullet velocity, does hinder your aim walking movement speed, but ultimately is the best choice for the playstyle for this gun. Now moving over to the optic, we are taking the Axial Arms 3x zoom. Now I usually say with a lot of the Cold War assault rifles, you can take the SUSAP multi-zoom. However, in this instance, I believe the ADS speed on this gun is too slow to be taking that. You don't want to be extending that out any more than it is already. So take the Axial Arms 3x zoom. And moving over to the underbarrel, I personally take the Spetsnaz Speed Grip, as I don't think you need any assistance with the vertical recoil control. So you might as well help yourself out with that sprinting move speed just to make yourself that little bit more mobile. But ultimately, if you do struggle with the recoil, then do take the Spetsnaz Grip over the Spetsnaz Speed Grip. And then lastly, moving on to the ammunition, we're taking the Spetsnaz 60 round mag. Well, I'm just going to leave the full build on the screen for a couple of seconds here, but thanks for watching. Make sure you hit that like and subscribe button, and I'll see you in the next one.